We are going to go into this ice cream shop, but I don't want to wait in the line. So I'm going to go talk to these girls and finesse my way in. Me and Matt are going to get in quick. I don't even know what I'm going to say to them. Hey, excuse me. Can we be friends with you guys for like 20 minutes?
Should I make sure I pause to get in the line?
Yes.
No.
Yes, please.
You have a smoothie. You have a cameraman.
This is Matt.
That's your cameraman.
Is Matt going to be our friend too?
Yeah, he's going to be your friend too. I swear.
I mean, I think we should let them be our friends.
I guess.
Okay.
Yeah, why are you filming us?
It's for X videos.
Like XXX? Like,
okay,
Ava, I'm done. Like, don't worry about like, it. Porn? Don't worry about it. Is it okay if we walk in with you?
I guess.
Okay,
yeah.
Thank you. We're good, Matt. We're good. Okay, so the place that I originally wanted to go that I always go in Panama City, the line was like super, super long. So these kind ladies let us break in line with them. And this is like not as good as the other place, but yeah, this is pretty valid milkshake. I don't even know, what are we gonna do now? Oh, wait, I gotta get a tattoo first. Yeah, we're gonna get a tattoo. It's gonna be sick. I'm about to solve world peace with this tattoo. You guys are gonna love it, I promise. All right, what do we think? All right, thank this kind lady here. She did an amazing job. I'm gonna have to walk like this for a while so it dries, but I think this tattoo personally is like freaking sick. So yeah, anyways, no division. You know, I have a story that I've yet to tell any social media app. So the first time I ever went to a strip club, and yes, like, yeah, I've been to a strip club, okay? Like, don't crucify me. I was like 19 and I was in LA and it was around Halloween, right? So I was going to all these like celebrity, like B-tier celebrity, like Halloween parties. And we leave one and it's like 3 o'clock in the morning and we go to this like ginormous like apartment building, like penthouse, weird looking thing. They don't tell me what's going on. I have no idea. I thought we were going to like somebody's house for like a party or some shit. So we walk in and literally, you guys know the movies where it's like, there'll be a bunch of old men who are like sitting at like a table all playing poker with like millions of dollars and there's like strippers like on their backs, like rubbing their shoulders and stuff. That was literally what was going on in that place. I was like, it was like a $2 million penthouse or something like that. And I walk in and I have to pee, right? I don't care about anything going on here. I don't want to go to a strip club because I didn't want to go to a strip club. So I go straight to the back because that's where they said the bathroom was. It's just like one bathroom. It's like a half bath, right? And I walk in and there's two strippers in there and they're just like chilling, doing their makeup and stuff. I guess they weren't on shift yet. And I had to pee and I was like, I have to pee. And they're like, okay. So they start like talking to me, like feeling up on me and stuff, like trying to get me to like, I guess, pay them money to like, I don't know what they were trying to do. I was not interested in any of that. And so they like talking to me and stuff. And I was like, I really got to pee. So I turn around and I'm looking at them, like waiting for them to like leave the bathroom. And they just don't. And they just look at me and I'm just like, so I got to pee right here. And I didn't say that aloud, but like in my head, I was like, okay, whatever. So I literally had to pee in front of two strippers in the back of a strip. I've never told you this story. That's crazy. Yeah. Okay, so I walk out of the bathroom and everybody else around the table, there was like a girl on like a pole, like doing some like weird spiritual stuff. She looked like she was like possessed or something. I peed and I left and I left and I took a $70 Uber back home while everybody else was like sitting in chairs around her, just like looking at her like food. They were looking at this woman like food and just like holding money and just like throwing it down. I was like, bro.
Yeah. Are you on birth control? No? Okay. Word. See you later then.
What's up guys? Matt just sent a picture of my feet to a bunch of people on Snapchat. Literally just straight up like put his phone down, took a picture of my feet and sent it to like who knows how many people.
Dude, it was my good morning streets.
So we're about to partake of the forbidden pre-workout. This little pink stuff is called Cialis, okay? Cialis is used to treat old man, wait, okay. Cialis is basically, it's definitely a healthy thing that men use to be healthier. Honestly, it's like the best pre-workout you could take for a pump. Not pre-workout, but like, I would say the best pump product that you can take. Cialis, baby. The pump is gonna be insane. Mm. What am I doing? This dissolves in your mouth.
It's gonna be just chilling in my mouth for the next 15 minutes. But about to hit pre-workout. I don't have a shaker bottle because I don't be doing like fancy stuff like that. But we do have this like water bottle that I got at the gas station, Busy Bee water, something like that. And today we are running the Rise Ring Pop. Rise Ring Pop is probably my second favorite pre. I just didn't bring Godzilla because my new Godzilla has not come in the mail yet, but it literally gets to my house today, but my house is like 5 hours away from here. So I have to find a way to freaking put this in here without getting it all over the floor. We're probably gonna be done off camera, but code Marsh for Rise Subs. Give me a freaking message, a screenshot if you get anything with the code, and I'll be sure to follow the homies back. You know, you guys support me, I support you, because you're a homie, you know what I mean? So that's how it works. We're gonna take pre, go get a workout. This Cialis is like not melted in my mouth yet. So yeah, dudes, gonna be a sick freaking workout today. We got push focused upper body, which means we're gonna do a little bit of everything with an emphasis on chest, delts, and the crap. Cialis fell out of my mouth, I gotta rinse it off. Okay, yeah, good as new, right? But yes, I'm done talking. Code Marsh, Rise Subs, like the freaking video, and watch this dope montage that Matt's about to make. Alright, dude, so workout is over. Now, the part of the video that I most want you guys to watch, listen to, perceive, we're bringing deep Marsh out, okay? Like emotional, vulnerable, like that kind of Marsh. So yeah, so I want to talk about this whole like fitness industry thing that I guess I'm a part of, that you guys see from an outsider point of view, and if you're a creator then you see it from an insider point of view. But so basically you guys see the community of, you know, this fitness Instagram, TikTok, YouTube kind of industry, and you know, everybody like wants to be a part of it, it seems like, anyways. I remember whenever I first started making content and stuff, it was like I just wanted to be a part of like this whole community. Like everybody was like supportive of each other kind of community, where it was like I just wanted to be a part of that, you know. I wanted to be like an influencer, I wanted to be a YouTuber, a TikToker, whatever, man. And
you know, I worked really hard, obviously. I started making content and stuff. And as I've become more and more involved in this community, this industry, I've come to realize how much I dislike this industry. Like, whenever people tell me, like, oh, you're a fitness influencer, I'm like, no, like, you know, I don't like being called that. And the reason I don't like being called a fitness influencer is because of how the fitness industry is. This fitness industry is awful. I hate the fitness industry. And don't get me wrong, I'm very blessed to be in the position that I am, and I'm very blessed that God has placed me in a position where I can, you know, help make a positive impact on as many people as I have. That's like super, super awesome. But like I said, what you guys don't understand is that the fitness industry is not a happy place anymore. It's not a place of like support. It's not a welcoming environment. It's really just awful. So yeah, I'm gonna tell you guys kind of why. I know kind of I clickbaited the video with like exposing the fitness industry, and I kind of am. But in a way, this is kind of something that if you guys just look closely, you can see, like, it's plain as day. So basically, what I see most in the fitness industry right now is division, negativity, freaking controversy, just conflict. And I see people just like purposefully spreading negativity, creating division and creating conflict between communities. And it's literally just breaking this whole fitness community, fitness industry apart. You know, like I see, you know, like the whole Raw Gear versus Young LA, Soosh versus Bradley Martin, like all this BS. And that's like, I don't feel like that's how it used to be. Like, I feel like whenever I first started getting involved with the community and everything, it wasn't like that. It was like a community. What community means together. Like, we're all together. We're all supporting each other. We're all here because we want to help each other become better. We want to help each other, you know, do more and accomplish more and become better versions of ourselves. And like I was saying, like, now it's just like a whole bunch of people who are just divided, and it's like a constant war. I opened my freaking TikTok and literally everything is about controversy. Everything's about conflict. Everything's about, oh, Young LA versus Roger, Seuss versus Brad, freaking, you know, like blah, 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 blah versus blah, 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 blah. Like, whose side are you on? Like, you know what I mean? And it's really just like, why do we have to have all this division? Why do we have to create conflict and controversy? Oh, she's bad. Oh wait, sorry. Back to the freaking speech little thing I'm trying to tell you guys. And like I said, anyways, so all this division and stuff, and that's why I say that I don't like being a part of it. You know what I mean? You guys think that this like fitness industry is all like love and positivity and everybody's just pouring out love for each other. No, it's really, really, really not. And it's really just a bunch of division, conflict. And I know I've said this over and over and over, but I'm really, really trying to get this across to you guys. Like, if you are wanting to become a part of the fitness industry, if you are a creator or you want to become a creator, please, please, please do not look at these creators that you see, you know, majority of them who just like create controversy and, you know, division and conflict, and, you know, for views, and be like, oh yeah, I want to be like them. You know what I mean? Like, you guys can have like your role models or whatever, but I don't know. For me personally, it's like, I'm looking at those guys and I'm like, stop. Like, I'm looking at those guys and I'm like, why are you doing this? Like, you know it's causing division, you know it's causing controversy, you know it's causing conflict and negativity. Why are you doing it? I don't understand. But I see a lot of people following their example. And like I said, I'm not naming names or anything. Like, this isn't any one person in particular. But it's just a bunch of people, you know. And what I don't want to see is the fitness community to continue to do that. You know, one thing that me and a lot of my homies, I don't have a lot of homies. And the reason why is because of everything I'm saying. You know what I mean? You guys don't see me filming with a bunch of people. You guys don't see me collabing with people who aren't like my homies. And the reason it being is because I do not want to be associated with all that stuff. You know what I mean? Like, I don't have anything against them, but like I said, like, I do not want to be a part of this negativity, this freaking division and all this stuff, that the controversy. Like, that's not me. Like, I want this to be a community again. Like, I want this. That's why, you know, I have a Discord. That's why I respond to you guys as much as possible in my Instagram DMs. That's why I talk to you guys, you know, respond to comments on freaking TikTok and stuff, because I like the community. I liked the community that the fitness industry was before it became all about this controversy and stuff, you know. And one thing, you know, I know me and Jeremy kind of went through a little rough patch, but like, one thing that we both have in common and that we both found was like very rare
for people to think about was just the you know, I don't know, the dissatisfaction of all the division, you know what I mean? Because I've met so many people who are like, yeah, let's just make videos, let's hate on this person, let's, you know, do this and this and this. And every once in a while, I'll kind of like jokingly think, oh yeah, that'd be funny if we like clown so-and-so. But like, seriously, at the end of the day, it's like, I don't know, with my content, the last thing I want to do is cause more division, is cause more conflict and negativity. I want this fitness community to be a place where everyone's welcome, everybody can feel like they can be themselves, and everybody doesn't have to freaking choose a side or freaking not, I don't know. I want people to be able to make decisions for themselves and not just meat ride somebody that they think. So like, you know, like, cause this might not be making any sense, but like there's creators who will be like, oh yeah, like, you know, screw this company on their story. And then everybody has to pick a side, right? Everybody who watches them and supports them, they have to pick a side. It's like, oh yeah, I can either agree with him and say, screw this company or screw this person too. Or I can disagree with them, which they don't want to do if they're like, you know, meat riding these people. And you know, then I'm not cool in their eyes. You know what I mean? And nobody wants to be not cool in the eyes of the person that they look up to. So, you know, then they just feed into it more and they cause it more. And then, you know, they make videos about it and they, you know, comment about it and they go and, you know, hate on other people because, you know, one person said it was cool to hate on a brand or other people. And again, not naming names. I'm not trying to put anybody down with this video. I'm just expressing something that I'm seeing to be very, very prevalent in the industry that I very much dislike about it. You know what I mean? And you know, I've said it before and I'll say it again. This industry is not what you think it is. It's a very, very lonely industry. And you know, whenever I think about how lonely it is, I think about like in the beginning, right? So I know not everybody watching this video, you know, maybe Christian or whatever, but you know, I'm going to speak from a Christian's point of view simply just because like I'm a proclaiming Christian. So, you know, this is just how I think. But you know, in the beginning, God created Adam, right? He was the first human. He was the first person to, you know, ever walk the earth. And he created Adam, and that was the only human that he created. And then after he created Adam, he was dissatisfied. He was like, this is not good. You know what I mean? And he said that it was not good for man to be alone. And that's why he created Eve. Now, he didn't create Eve to fight Adam and to have conflict with Adam and butt heads with Adam. He created Eve to help Adam raise a family, to help Adam, you know, raise a community, to, you know, like have a family, to have like, you know, bring things up, you know, to work together, to have a better life, to work together, to both be better off as individuals, but, you know, together as well. And that's how I see this whole like fitness industry thing, right? I see all these people and I'm like, you know, it's just division, division, division. Let's divide. Let's like all fight. Let's all butt heads. And I'm like, bro, like God didn't put us on this earth to freaking butt heads. He didn't put us on this earth to have disagreements and to freaking hate on each other and cause division. He put us on this earth to be a community. You know what I mean? He created freaking Bradley Martin. He created Sush. He created me. He created Jeremy Foster. He created all these people to be a community, to help build each other up, help build the community up. Because like that's like I said, that's what we're freaking put on this earth to do. And I know that's like, you know, some of that's on some like spiritual shit that a lot of you guys may not be into. But for me as a Christian, that's just kind of how I see things. And I don't know, that's kind of like, I guess, the root of my dissatisfaction with this fitness, you know, industry thing that everybody wants to be a part of. But yeah, guys, I said all that to kind of say that, you know, just like, please, guys, please see, you know, the industry for what it is. See, you know, your existence for what it is. And don't just feed into the negativity, guys. Don't feed into all this, like, you know, all this, like, just I mean conflict and, you know, division. And I know it's like, it's really easy to, because the people that you may support, wow, yeah, I'm getting distracted, guys, I'm so sorry. I know it may be easy because, you know, the people that you support and stuff, like you want to support them, and if they're causing division, you want to like support them in that. But like, please, please, please look past that, look above that. Do not idolize these people. Don't idolize me, you know. I know some of you guys may idolize me. Don't idolize me, and try to make decisions based on how you think and feel and based on your own, you know, your own experience and everything. So yeah, guys, that's pretty much all I'm gonna say about it. Me and Matt are gonna find some freaking food, probably screw on with some people, maybe get a few phone numbers, not gonna lie. Bro, there's some baddies here. I'm getting distracted.
Serious Mark.
Look, okay, so I'm not gonna lie, guys. I like women, okay? I like women. I'm a man. Whenever I see a woman who is very attractive, I'm going to look and I'm gonna be like, oh, nice. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not gonna, and not in a disrespectful way, but like, yeah. So I'm not trying to be like some perfect little golden boy Christian who never does anything wrong. I'm not trying to pretend to be that, okay? I'm gonna just like be normal. And if like, you know, like, yeah, I'm a Christian and stuff, but like, yeah, I like women too. You know what I mean? So anyways, we're gonna freaking park. We're gonna find some food, not women, probably women too. And yeah, maybe buy some stuff at some stores or something. I don't know. Peace.